Let's go, dude. Let's go.
I love it, boy.
Here's the shot.
Get off my back. Kids can't even watch this at home.
We tip things off by shining the spotlight on a sweet shooting three-time All-Star and Olympian on the Milwaukee Bucks, Ray Allen.
Ray makes some critical shots. I call them, critical condition.
I'll tell you, don't leave Ray Allen open. Just do not leave Ray Allen alone.
After he's finished with you, you're in critical condition.
Allen, three on the shot clock, two on the shot clock, three in the net.
Beautiful. This is a Ray Allen show, ladies and gentlemen.
Being a leader, people always say that this is the backbone team. This is the foundation.
Everybody got a job. It's going to come out. Everybody do their job. We won't have nothing to worry about.
My goal out there always is to make the team better. That's something that I've kind of relished.
Ray's so cool and so smooth and so fluid. Sometimes I don't think Ray's playing hard. Now that I've coached him for 3 years, I know he is.
Everything he does looks like it's in slow motion.
He's kind of a quiet assassin in terms of what he does on the offensive end.
I heard he's not tough enough, he's not this, he's not that, because he don't verbally say things back to opponents. That's him. That is Ray Allen.
Knocks down another one. They cannot stop Ray Allen.
Being consistent is enough to intimidate your opponent.
Ray Allen, a huge triple, 7 for 9 on three-pointers.
When an opponent comes in and they see that consistent 23, 24 points a game, they know it's coming up.
Allen back with a three ball and a dagger.
But I might score, 40 plus, and that's the unknown that's out there.
Ray has 31 points, 74 points in less than 2 games.
I don't care what you're doing out on the floor defensively. I'm already in your head. You've been intimidated.
I like that. I like the demeanor of more anger, more intimidation, more intensity.
He's still growing as a basketball player.
I think what's evolved me from when I first came into the league, now every game I think to myself, we have to win this game. This is a game we're supposed to win. We got to win it. This team shouldn't beat us. It's a game, but I have to take a business approach to it. Let the people have fun, but let me go out here and work my hardest, and then everything's gonna take care of itself.
Last summer, Kobe Bryant had a chance to meet his fans overseas as he traveled around the world. Let's join the Lakers star on his trip to China in this week's Total NBA.
Supposed to be on vacation, but this is when the real work kicks in. Going to China to promote Adidas basketball, but also to promote my new sneaker coming out, as well as the apparel, the Kobe 2 line. We have some interesting events lined up, which includes a trip to the Great Wall of China.
First time ever a person is playing basketball in the Great Wall of China.
This is the only way to get up.
Yeah. We're all excited. We're all looking forward to just seeing what it looks like and trying to get a gauge of the magnitude of this thing. I was supposed to be a judge for a dunk competition that they were having. They set up a court. They set up a basket. I don't know how they did it. I don't know if they used a helicopter or whatever to get up there. And they had kids there playing a game of basketball. Some of those kids had some serious hops. Some of those dunks were pretty creative. They were having a good time and enjoying the game. When the competition was through, then it was my turn to get up and dunk a little bit for the fans and give them what they wanted to see. The energy there was incredible, man. It had my adrenaline pumping. I wanted to jump over the basket. It had me so psyched up.
was a thrilling moment for me.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. So much fun. I love it. It's great.
For bios on all your favorite NBA players, be sure to log on to the league's official website, NBA.com. NBA Jam will be right back. Now, let's put the focus on Lakers big man Shaquille O'Neal.
I want to be known as a sinner. 7-1, 3-15, I'm nothing but power. When I'm on a basketball court, I mean nothing but business. I know when I'm on the court, a lot of things can happen.
Absolutely.
Oh, what a great play. Nobody is going to stop me from getting to the basket, especially one player. It's impossible. It's against the law. I have about 150 moves.
What a combination of finesse and power.
I got the whole package.
He's become a solid sixth man and one of the league's most improved players. The Clippers' Quentin Richardson stars in NBA Shorts.
Bring the funk, Q.
Dance a little bit. Can we stay?
Do you know my name?
Hi, I'm Quentin Richardson, and I play guard for the LA Clippers.
Well, that is some flash.
Already.
Oh, no, this don't look nothing like me.
Gringo Richardson.
Whatever stops you from dreaming, whatever tries to stop you from living.
He's an offensive machine, ladies and gentlemen.
Flip it.
I'm kind of all over the place with my game a little bit.
The lock, the jam.
My style of play is I shoot threes.
Bingo! Number 10 for Q.
Slash to the hole.
5 on the clock. Oh, that was great body control by Quentin Richardson.
Get rebounds.
Miles misses. Oh, Quentin Richardson, unbelievable.
I'm not supposed to get rebounds over bigger people or take the ball from them. So when I do that, it makes me feel good. Post up.
Richardson inside as well as outside.
Just kind of quick tempo.
Jackson up court in the passing lane. Quentin Richardson rolls his eyes.
I try and bully smaller people in a post.
Richardson inside. He'll go to the other side. So he shows the other facet of his game.
Bang him around and overpower him and use my size advantage over him and punish him in the post.
With you at, right here. I knew that.
So come on.
Richardson is able to put it down.
Feel me.
Richardson with the bucket. I want the ball, says Quentin Richardson. Mike.
Michael Jordan is the greatest player that ever played a game. I'm glad I played against him all summer.
Quentin Richardson worked out with Michael Jordan all summer long. Might be as good a sixth man as you'll find in the NBA. He has taken over this fourth quarter for the Los Angeles Clippers.
I want to be known as a great player. And anything that comes along with that, that's good enough for me. I definitely want to play for a long time and continue to enjoy myself. And I think as long as I do all of those things, you know, everything else, winning and championships, all that stuff can come.
Next, we go on the scene with Brian Grant of the Miami Heat, who took us along on his latest deep-sea fishing trip.
B. Grant, Miami Heat.
Grant watching for the rebound.
Doing it Miami style, baby. We're about to go out and we're about to catch some big ones.
Oh, what a basket. You see that long arm go out and look like a fishing rod.
All right, we're going fishing. I've been fishing since I was a little boy. My papa used to take me fishing in Ohio along the river in the creeks. And then once I got out to the West Coast, started salmon fishing, man, and I've just really gotten more and more into it. Right now, it's just time to relax, kind of take our mind off everything, and get out there and go fishing. Oh, baby, come to Papa. Hoping to get some sailfish, and I'd like to hook up on a shark, too, because I've never caught a shark, just to see one. Hopefully, we can get a kingfish. Good eating.
Nice jig there. Extra pressure. Break him off.
Oh, he broke. Oh, that was my kingfish. It's all good. We're roughing it. We're roughing it. You might even see us hook up here in the next few minutes.
There he is. There he is. Oh! Big sail there.
Oh, yeah, baby. I seen him jump. Oh, that's a nice one. That's a nice one, baby. Whoa. Oh!
Happiness is not a fish that you can catch.
Okay, swing them in. Keep your rod down low. Bring them in slow. Low and slow.
Oh, there she is. Yeah. Oh, look at that purple baby. Oh, yeah. Fish.
Go
finally.
Heat. Go heat.
Today was pretty nice. We were able to bag this one fish. Unfortunately, I was not the person to bring that fish in. My buddy from Oregon was. I had actually had the bigger fish on earlier that day, but he was able to shake himself off the hook. Hooked up three times, got one out of three. It wasn't a bad day.
NBA Jam is coming back with a look at last year's memorable Eastern Conference Finals.
NBA Jam, 24 seconds with Alonzo Mourning.
My nickname is Zoe.
Zoe, what, son?
I grew up in Chesapeake, Virginia. I love to eat pasta. If I wasn't a basketball player, I'd probably be a teacher. My favorite TV show is Seinfeld. My favorite cartoon is Fat Albert. My pet's name is Lucky. He's a boxer. I have a fish. I don't know his name. That's 24 seconds with me, Alonzo Moore.
Now, let's take an all-access look at last year's Eastern Conference Finals, a seven-game battle between the Bucks and the Sixers.
Snow, you got Cassell. Allen's got Ray Allen, so we got to be attached to those guys.
Your focus, your discipline, your professionalism is going to be tested, and then your attitude is going to be tested.
I thought it was a great series. Guys made incredible sacrifices for me.
Iverson wills his way. He will not be denied.
Allen specifically, he didn't want to acknowledge the fact that he was hurt.
You got to wonder about Allen Iverson's health.
I think now is the time that we have to definitely take advantage of him being disabled at this point.
We felt like there were so many people that they wanted to see Allen Iverson and those guys, and we were just, you know, the boys from Milwaukee. I wanted to win so bad.
And the Milwaukee Bucks will take a 2-1 edge.
It was a very good basketball series, both strategy-wise and performance-wise. The ping-ponging of win one at home, lose one at home, we win one at home, and then we lose game four.
Philadelphia 76ers, a very impressive win to even up this Eastern Conference Final.
Game five was a pivotal game.
13 seconds remaining, and the Bucks will have a chance to win it.
I know this is hard. Suck it up. It ain't easy what you have to go through, but just suck it up.
Robinson knocked away by McKee. Robinson puts it up. Oko to Ogo. And the Sixers win to take a 3-2 lead.
I mean, this is... I don't know if we have anything left to win next game.
You got 24 minutes in your building. Play basketball the right way.
And the Bucks refuse to die.
It's so fitting that this series is going seven games. These two teams so evenly matched.
If we played 10 times or 20 times, it would come out 5-5 or 10-10. And probably in the end, the home court was the difference.
You can't get going in this type of game, there's a problem, man.
Iverson exploding here in game seven. He's got 40.
Hey, isn't it fun, man?
Yeah, man.
And for the first time in 18 years, the Sixers are going back to the NBA Finals.
One, two, three. Playoffs!
Stay tuned. NBA Jam will return with our Jam of the Week.
Hey, I'm Steve Francis of the Houston Rockets, and coming up next is the Jam of the Week.
Time now for the latest NBA highlights and a song from Usher. You don't have to call in our Jam of the Week.
Situations will arise in our lives.
Oh!
Winding down, best circle routine, the Marley wild shot.
Yeah, Chandler makes it good
with a slam. Down there to slam it back.
Sonics up one with 6:52 to go in the third. Up the floor, Lewis. To Radmanovic. James right down to the middle of the lane. Nobody's gone. Here come the Bulls. The left.
We'll be back in just a moment with Retro NBA. This left-handed point guard starred for 14 seasons in the NBA. Here's John Lucas, as seen through the eyes of the Cavaliers' Trajan Langdon in Retro NBA. John Lucas was the number one pick in the 1976 draft, and he went on to success in the NBA as one of the league's most respected floor leaders. After his playing days, John brought his leadership to the league's coaching ranks. Today, he's head coach of the Cleveland Cavaliers and has earned the admiration of his players, including guard Trajan Langdon.
What stands out to me watching John Lucas play in his games is high energy. His ability to lead, his ability to push the ball up the floor, get everybody involved, as well as score for himself. I would describe myself as a shooter, somebody who shoots the ball very well, and that's my main threat, but also as a person who plays, who has a lot of respect for the game of basketball. I'm similar to Coach Lucas, right? I give it my all. His enthusiasm as a player has really carried over with his enthusiasm as a coach. When I met Coach Lucas for the first time, my impressions of him as a coach were just like he was as a player, very high energy, he's very positive. No matter what you did on the court, he just kept, you know, telling you to work hard, stay positive. You know, he wants you to get better. And he's a great leader, a great motivator.
Oh, come on! Stay together!
He demands us playing together. He demands us playing hard. On both ends of the floor, although, you know, one of his statements, his key statements he makes all the time is offense beats defense. Offense is action, defense is a reaction. He feels like the action is always first. Good defense can always be beat by a better move and a better shot. I think a lot of people may call Coach Lucas unorthodox as a coach because he goes a lot by feel.
The original! Don't be fooled by false prophets!
A lot of coaches come into practice with a practice plan. He may come in with a plan in his head on what he wants to accomplish that day, but if he feels something is more important, he'll scrap that plan. I don't know how many coaches in the NBA don't sit down during a game, but he's one of them. I mean, he doesn't sit down. He's just up on that sideline pacing because I think he's looking at every player and how they're playing because he wants to help them, because he wants to see how he can help us win. And I think that just shows how perfect he wants his team to be. He doesn't just see it as teaching basketball. He comes in every day and he tries to get a feel for everybody. My personality and Coach Lucas' personality are almost 180 degrees from each other. I bring a lot of energy, but I'm probably not as demonstrative. I'm not as vocal as he is.
Motion, run it!
The kind of coach you are is a reflection of the kind of person you are. He's a very honest person, he's a very honest coach. He'll tell you, you know, what you're doing wrong, what you're doing right, what he thinks you need to be doing better. And, you know, he feels that if he's going to be truthful with you as a coach, he needs to be truthful with you as a person. And so he'll tell you his downfalls, what he's been through in the past. I think there's a lot of people that never do recover from an addiction. And for him to recover and want to help other people do that, I think is great.
That's it for this.